Gorgeous start to this Wednesday. We fell into the 60s for most of the Brazos Valley. 69 degrees in Bryan College Station, 64 in Hearn, as well as Fairfield, expecting another night of upper 60 degree readings across the Brazos Valley due to the dry air remaining in place. So get out tomorrow morning and enjoy the cooler temperatures. Pretty tight gradient across the Brazos Valley right now. We have triple digits across the southwestern zone. And as you work your way toward the north and the east, temperatures falling into the low 90s. We're sitting at 95 degrees in Bryan College Station, 95 in Caldwell, 91 degrees in Mejia. So the temperatures out there are warm across the southwestern zone, a little more manageable across northeastern parts of the Brazos Valley, 100 degrees in Del Rio, 96 in Midland, 90 in Amarillo. Taking a look at the satellite and radar, nothing going on here in the Brazos Valley. We are seeing some activity, though, out across western parts of Texas. This activity is not going to impact the Brazos Valley. Going to start to fizzle out as it continues to work its way south toward the Texas Hill Country. Tomorrow morning, not a cloud in the sky across the Brazos Valley. Dry air continuing to filter in behind that cold front that worked its way through yesterday and tomorrow afternoon. Going to be absolutely beautiful out there. Wall-to-wall sunshine across the Brazos Valley. Low relative humidities with a light northerly breeze. Get outside and enjoy that weather if you have the opportunity, because it's not too often in late August that we see low relative humidity across the Brazos Valley. No significant rain chances across our area over the next few days heading throughout the weekend, looking like it's going to remain dry. But as we head into early in the middle of next week, looking like a surge of tropical moisture going to feed into the Brazos Valley, possibly due to a tropical system. We'll continue to monitor that. We're definitely going to see an uptick, though, in the precipitation chances from Monday into Wednesday. Some of that rain could be heavy, especially across that eastern and southern zone. These are the areas it looks like they could be favored for heavier rain, and especially as you get toward coastal parts of Texas. The two systems we're tracking, one right now in the Central Caribbean, this now has an 80% chance of development over the next few days, a 90% chance for that system that is to the east of the Windward Islands. This actually may become a tropical storm by the 10 o'clock show. So I'll have an update on that at that time to let you know if this actually develops into a tropical storm by 10 o'clock tonight. Main question is, where are these systems going to track? There's still a lot of uncertainty right now, but heading into the late week, and we're going to notice that first system working its way across the Yucatan Peninsula into the southern Gulf of Mexico. This is the one we're focused on in the Brazos Valley. It looks like this could provide impacts to the Brazos Valley. Also going to see that second system working its way toward Hispaniola as we head late into the weekend. Notice we have a relative weakness across the Gulf of Mexico, so this is going to act like a magnet and kind of try to pull these storms in the Gulf of Mexico. That's what the models are indicating right now. Still a lot of uncertainty, but as we head into early next week, looking like that upper level ridge across the Atlantic going to kind of build toward the west. This is going to steer that second system into eastern parts of the Gulf of Mexico, and we're going to keep an eye on that first system as it tries to approach possibly the Texas or Louisiana coast Tuesday, Wednesday time frame. This looks like it's going to create an uptick in moisture for the Brazos Valley, and also that second system looking like it could possibly work its way up toward the southeastern parts of the U.S. So a lot to keep an eye on, still a lot of questions, but overall looking like both of these systems are going to work their way into the Gulf of Mexico by early to middle next week. If you live along the Gulf of Mexico, keep in mind you want to continue to check that forecast for updates over the next several days, as there is a lot of uncertainty in the forecast. 10-day forecast for us showing temperatures going to be nice out there, below average for the next few days. We see a little spike in the temperatures on Sunday, but Tristan, we have a pretty good chance of rain heading into next week with those tropical systems that try to sneak their way into the Gulf of Mexico.
Chris, I don't know what I did in a past life to celebrate 95 degrees, but I'm going to take it.
95 degrees, low humidity, you really can't beat that late August.
You can't, but it's still going to be hot. I still am going to be dripping in sweat as soon as I step outside, but it's better than triple digits. So
oh, 100%. How was your workout this morning? Did you enjoy the cooler temperatures?
It was nice. I mean, was it as nice as I was dreaming about? No, but it was cooler than past 8 o'clock workouts in the morning. So, like I said, can't complain too much.
Nope, beggars can't choose.
All right, thank you, Chris. We're going to have more sports coming up next.